Jake just being a human sacrifice, and he wins. Hank goes long.
And Jake says he's the best of the office. Here. Look at the emotion from Jake Moore. Wow. Win.
And then the firm handshake in the arena.
Fights back, losing game one. What a great match. What a
I felt bad for Hank because I was just playing my game, and I got excited for myself. But I guess the crowd reaction was just me alphaing Hank, which was not the intention. I just had my back against the wall because I was facing back-to-back losses for the first time in my career.
When you said, I am the best ping pong player in this office, if it wasn't to alpha Hank?
It was a statement to the office.
Yeah, it was alphaing the office.
Yeah, alphaing
him. Yeah, yeah. It was nothing against Hank personally, but he took all the heat.
No, I'll not be going to HR. I honestly didn't think it was as bad as it was. The reaction was kind of surprising, but...
Are you okay?
Did you respond to Dave?
I did respond. I was like, this is fine. You know, I appreciate the support, but I'll be back. This is nothing, you know. I've been here before. I'll be here again. Just got to fight back.
What did you think?
I was shocked. You know what it was like? It was like when they interview a serial killer's neighbors, and they're like, he's a really nice guy. Like, he said hello. We'd see him when he was walking the dog, and then one day you wake up and the person is killed, like, 15 people, and you're like, what? That was what I saw when I saw Jake going crazy. He's the BTK serial killer.
You're comparing me to a serial killer?
Yeah. I mean, not actually.
So many times that O.J. Simpson didn't kill somebody. And that 0.1% of the time, it's like, yeah, we should.
We're going to save this
for
the show.
About it?
Yeah, we're going to talk. Yes, I was going to lead the show with this.
Okay. Well, it was funny when they walked in to the interview straight from that. So,
well,
like,
no,
we
they
didn't
both
even know.
No, because they both were they
it was
both
an interview.
The reason why we didn't talk about it on Friday's show, Jake was embarrassed because that was an outburst, and Hank was embarrassed because he got alphaed by Jake. So PFT and I had no idea because we were interviewing Brandon Staley. And we would have needed either of them to bring it up, and neither of them brought it up because they were both equally as embarrassed in their own way. So we sat there on Friday. I was like, how do we not talk about it? So it is going to lead the show tonight.
Are you okay mentally, from a mental standpoint?
Yes, I'm as hungry as I've ever been. I'm ready to go. I'm locked in, you know.
No, I didn't ask if you were hungry. Are you okay?
I'm great.
Do you need a hug?
No.
Looks like you might need a hug.
It's not your fault.
It's not your fault.
It's not your fault.
I know. I know it's not my fault.
It's not your fault.
I know.
Today is Monday, May 10th, and we have something we have to discuss in this studio. Let me just play the audio real quick so that people can... So,
I am
whoa,
the best.
Wait. Oh, it's playing again. So, you're probably saying to yourself, hey, didn't this happen on Thursday? Well, you can feel the tension in this studio. And a funny thing happened on Thursday when we taped. I think we had equal amounts of embarrassment, Jake, by becoming the number one alpha on the show, and Hank by being Jake's straight up bitch. So we're now, by the way, girl boss energy revoked.
Transferred. Yeah.
Revoked.
Jake's got it now.
No longer has it. I don't know how to proceed. This has been on my mind all weekend that Jake Marsh, our darling Jake, is a stone cold killer. Fellas,
do you have anything to say for yourself?
I feel bad for Hank.
Oh my God, shut up, Jake.
That makes it so much worse. I love it.
I had zero intention of him getting humiliated the last 3 days.
Oh
zero.
My God. It just happened. It just happened.
And he knows that too.
I love how every time Jake apologizes,
that's not true.
It's way worse.
He's trying to be serious, and he's, I think in his heart of hearts, he's coming from a good place, but when you say things like...
It does it when we play too. It's extremely
I did not
painful.
Mean for Hank to get totally emasculated
by me. I'm sorry that
your
feelings got hurt, bitch. Hey, Jake,
I'm the best in the office.
Jake, I am the best one here. I treated him as an account today.
Explain the background.
He's my burner person. So most people have burners,
And I was like, that's great. Burners are, you know, they've been around forever. I have a burner person, an actual person who exists, who I have the ability to tweet from his account. So if anyone ever gets mad, I can be like, no, that's literally Bob. He's a real person. So I tweeted today on Mother's Day, I'm a huge MILF guy, Bob. And then I went and I liked some porn tweets. So they show up under his liked tweets.
If Bob gets asked about it, he has to say that it was his thought?
Well, no, he can say it was me, but if the heat ever gets too hot, I'm like, it's literally a person. Like, here he is, Youngstown Bob. So he's the perfect out in anything I say. Seems it like was also person.
Seems like it's a no-win situation for Youngstown Bob.
He's gained like 7,000 followers. Yeah. It also was where I it was. It's,
also, he kind of didn't have a choice.
Yeah, he didn't really have a choice, and he's gained 7,000 followers. And it was mostly because it started with the tournament, NCAA tournament, because everyone was making fun of my picks being terrible. So I was like, I'm just going to tweet all my picks from Bob's account. So if they win, I can be like, oh, those are my picks. If they lose, I can be like, oh, no, those are Bob's. And then since then, I've just used it to, like, harass Rico and, like, porn tweets. You know, the usual stuff.